Greetings. In this video lecture, I want to explore some actual samples of expletive constructions that I found in the last batch of papers and use those examples to give us an insight into why expletive constructions are problematic and how we can fix them. So let's jump in. Let's remember what an expletive construction is. You've already read the web lecture a couple times, but just to remind you, it's a combination of a vague pronoun and a form of to be. So some examples are, excuse me, but not limited to, it is, it was, there is, there are, what is, what was, that is, that was, etc. Those kind of functions. And what we're going to see in the slides that come ahead is that these expletive constructions are almost always unnecessary and frequently create all sorts of other issues. The first one that they can create is some sort of wordiness and confusion. And here you see an initial sentence with an expletive construction in it. There it is. There was. And here you see my rewrite. Notice that the rewrite is simpler and clearer and builds around an active verb. Active verbs are important because they properly assign agency. In other words, they allow us to clearly state to our reader who's responsible for what and what caused what. So they significantly, active verbs significantly clarify logic, and expletive constructions significantly blur logic. And that's why the biggest reason we want to get them out of our prose. Here's another one from a sentence, a two-sentence sequence that was describing a blackout that occurred in 2011. I remember that one. And what the expletive construction does here, or there's two of them actually, they create some confusion about the relationships between ideas. So we've got it was here, and then over here we've got this is. So we've got two expletive constructions in back-to-back sentences. When that happens, you're almost always being seeing a red flag that says, combine us, combine us, combine us. And that's what I try to do here. I use an introductory clause during what became known as the Great Blackout of 2011, comma, 7 million people in San Diego County in Mexico lost power. I combine those two sentences into one and get rid of both the expletive constructions. I call that technique extraction. I pull out the constructions and then I rewrite the sentences to make them work. That's an extraction of the expletive constructions. And I think you can see that that second sentence really clarifies things. Structural problems. Sometimes the appearance of an expletive construction reveals a structural problem in the sentence, that the writer is missing an element of how to construct the logic of the sentence. And so what we see here is that this writer really wants to use a not only but also structure, which traditionally links two complete clauses, either dependent or independent, and needs to have parallel structure. And this sentence has problems with both. It doesn't have the also, it doesn't have a parallel structure, and the it is a warning sign to us of the problem. So I rewrite it, and notice now it says not only, but also, and it also has a parallel structure now. And by the way, as I'm looking at my rewrite, just goes to show, it can happen to the best of us, I actually don't need that comma there, because the comma is only needed before a coordinating conjunction like but, when I'm separating two independent clauses. But what I really have there are two subordinate clauses, right? The first one starts with because, the second one starts with because, so no comma is needed there. But the important thing is, I've removed the expletive construction, I've added the also that needs to be there, and I fixed the parallelism problem, so I have a sentence that now has parallel structure, even though I left that unnecessary comma in there. I'll have to fix that some future life. All right. One of the things that an expletive construction can do is signal to you that there's unnecessary language in the sentence, and that there are relationships that can be clarified if we remove that unnecessary language and reorganize things a little bit. So if you look at the original sentence, it says, it was simply because, and that it was, and even that simply, I think, just don't need to be there. They're just totally unnecessary language. And I see that because, and I say to myself, ooh, can I move that subordinate clause to the front of the sentence and then have the main clause and completely get rid of that expletive construction, and I end up with what I think is a much stronger sentence that uses subordination in a more powerful way to set up a cause and effect relationship. And so I really think that second sentence improves on the first one. Let's try another one. I got a couple more here to look at. Oh, one of the real bummers about expletive constructions is they actually can create grammar problems. And this sentence, the grammar problem that's created is a comma splice error. Everything that comes before the comma is an independent clause. Having relationships with people makes the day go by faster. I've got a subject or verb. After the comma, I've got another independent clause. It is always better, a better environment when everyone's getting along, etc., etc. An expletive construction is a subject-verb pairing. It's just that the subject is a vague pronoun. So in this case, the expletive construction is not only vague, not only confusing, but creates a comma splice error for the writer. And this is another ideal example of a sentence where an extraction really works. I'm just going to pull out that it is and see if I can reshape this sentence. I'm going to, just for the fun of it, try to keep the same language and see if I can play with a semicolon here. And I think my rewrite not only gets rid of the expletive construction, but also experiments with another technique that's kind of fun, which is a semicolon. I don't recommend using them all the time, but I think a few times in the paper that semicolon linking two independent clauses is good. It fixes the comma splice, and it also hints at a really immediate relationship between these two independent clauses. And I think that's true in this situation. So again, the second sentence I think productively builds on the first one. And I think this is our last one. This is a writer who was trying to do something really cool by using an introductory phrase after being there for a few weeks. I really like how the author is trying to use an introductory phrase to set a time context for an incident that's important to understanding what's happening in the essay. But then that expletive construction "there was" creates some confusion and undermines the really cool clarity that the introductory clause phrase could potentially provide. So again, I extract it and I revise it, moving the words around a little bit, playing with them a little bit, and I think the second sentence again is stronger. And again, it's this idea of agency, right? When we do an expletive construction, it blurs responsibility, it blurs causality, it blurs the different kind of logical relationships that we really want to clarify in our prose. When we shift, we get out an expletive construction, we extract it, and we put in a strong subject-verb pair, we get a better sentence. So I'm hoping that these few examples have been helpful to you. You might want to watch this PowerPoint without my narration, so it's available as a straight PowerPoint on the web page. Or you might want to just pause a few times and read through the sentences. You'll notice that in my narration, I did not read the sentences. So let me know if you want more examples or if I can clarify these ideas. But I think this brings us a step forward in the conversation about expletive constructions. See you out there in the course.